So we'll be doing this with a Google Sheet, which is one of the native file types in Google Drive, but you can also do it with any other file type. So if I were to right click on this picture, the share option is there and the get link option is there as well. But you'll be able to see a few more things if we do it with the sheet. So we'll right click on the sheet and we'll go down and we'll left click on share. So this window comes up and there's two main ways to share files. There's the way that you type the names of the specific people or groups that you want to share with, or you obtain a link to the spreadsheet and control ownership with that. First, we'll go over sharing with people and groups. So you can type the email address in here. It also kind of auto-populates with the most often used email addresses. Let's just pick Michael. And when you look over to the right, use this drop-down, there are three different permission levels. And these are very important if you're sharing files. We'll go up from the bottom. Editor is the most permissions. When you share a file with someone and you give them the privilege of being an editor, they can make any change that they want. If you go to commenter, this allows people to use the commenting functions inside of Google Drive to kind of have a conversation back and forth that doesn't actually modify the document. And your most protected sharing setting is viewer. That allows the person that you're sharing the file with to only look at it, not make any changes, nor make any comments. So we'll leave this on editor. And the next choice is whether or not we want to notify Michael. So we'll leave this checkmark to notify. This will send them an email. In the example I'm working on, it can also send a browser notification depending on how you have Drive set up. But this will send them a message. So we'll say, here's the file. We're getting very original with our message. And before we click send, let's go up and look at the gear icon. And keep in mind that if you make someone an editor, the default is that they can change permissions for someone else and they can reshare the file. Make sure you want that. Otherwise, remove the check mark. And whether or not you want people to be able to download, print, and copy. So we want to notify Michael, we'll click send. And when you look at the file now, there's a little icon of two people next to it, which indicates that that file is shared. If I left click on the file and click on view details, this is the history of me sharing it with Michael. When in details, you can also see who it's shared with. All right, so that's very important if you forget later and you need to look it up. All right, so I'll take the window that has my Google Drive. I'll put it on the left-hand side of the screen. And the browser screen with Michael's Google account was underneath. It's on the right-hand side. So first we're starting at his Gmail, and you can see that he got the invitation to edit. So this lets him know that you shared a file with him. If he were to click on it, it would describe the file, and you can just click here to open in Sheets. This is a spreadsheet that he got. He can make any changes that he wants, and he can comment back and forth with other people that are added to the file. And we should stop here for a moment to talk about how you use Google Drive. And if you're using Google Drive in a way that you actually access the files through your file system. So I use Google Drive File Stream here on Windows. Keep in mind that the Shared with Me folder doesn't show up. All right, so if I back up one, I'm seeing shared drives, which is something else. That's because I have a business account and I'm seeing my drive. There is no shared with me, but there is a workaround to this. Let's go back into Michael's account. Let's look at his shared with me. This is what I just sent to him. If he right clicks on it and says add shortcut to drive, that will add a link to it in his own Google Drive. You see it right here. Little icon shows that it's a shortcut. And now he'll be able to access that if he's using backup and sync or Drive File Stream. All right, let's go back to the main account that I'm using that has the original file in it. And we'll talk about some different ways to share it. So we'll right click on it again and we'll go to share. And we talked about sharing with people. Sharing with groups is a similar concept, but you have to have groups set up first. So let's get out of this screen for a minute, come up to the nine little dots here, left click on groups. And I've set up a few groups here. You can have as many as you want, but what they are is a collection of people, right? So if you share a file or folder with a group, you can then control who is in that group. So we see marketing here. Let's go back to this file, click on share. And if you start to type marketing, you can then share it with that group in the same way that you would share it with a person. All right, so that mostly covers sharing with people and groups. If you want more advanced sharing features, we'll click out of this for a minute. If you're using a Google Workspace account, there's something called Shared Drives. So I've linked to a video on Shared Drives. It's kind of its own topic, and you don't have access to that free account. But you can create drives, and each drive you can control the people and their permissions. So I've linked to that in the upper right-hand corner if you want to watch that. But we'll circle back to sharing, right-click on annual budget again, and go down to the other type of sharing, which is Git Link. So what this feature does is it gives you a link that points to this specific document. So if you left-click on Copy Link and you give someone this link, it will bring them here. But these controls below the link will control what happens when other people go to it. So this does work together with the option above. If you leave it on restricted, only the people that you've added can open the link. So you've added them here, you've already sent them an email, but if they lose the email or you just want to make it easier for them, you can come to Git Link, copy the link, send it to them in a message, and they can get back to the file. But the Git Link option can also be handy to share the file with a group of people through email. And you can reuse the link if you want to share, say, a folder of different files over and over again. So the different ways that you can share a link is you can restrict it, which we just talked about. That would only be, in this case, going to Michael in that marketing group if I had added it. Or you can restrict it to anyone in your company if you're using a business account, or anyone with the link. So if you click on anyone with the link, what that does is this makes this accessible to anyone that grabs it. And once they get the link, they don't need a username and password to log in order to see the spreadsheet. It just comes right up. So I've just copied that link. I'm using Google Chrome. I'll go up, I'll create an incognito window, which this just makes a browser window where the internet doesn't know who I am. We'll use that link, hit enter, and it lets me into the file. Now you see it let me in and view only, because that was a setting that I had. So we will go back to where I shared this from, and you can drop this down and you can give anyone on the internet editor privileges to this file if you wanted to. We'll turn that off. That always seems a little daunting, right? In this next video, we're going to talk about if you're using Docs or if you're using Slides, there's different ways to share files in which you can post it to the internet, but not have it load in Docs or Sheets. So it's kind of more like a web page. Here's the video on that in Google Docs, and I'll see you in that video. Thanks.